What's up YouTube, welcome to my channel Complete Tech Review and welcome to another walk around of the Avenger 220, and this one is in the PS6 variant. The Avenger 220 was always the crowd favorite, mainly because of the cruiser stance, and it has a wide and a very comfortable seat. In the PS6 variant, there are a couple of features which have been added. What are those? So let's look into it. So the 2020 Avenger Cruise 220 comes with the 220cc DDSI engine, which is BS6. The BS6 canister is integrated into the exhaust pipe and it gets a chrome treatment with a sensor. That is interesting. And also, if you see, the oil cooler also has chrome treatment with a single horn. So from a chrome point of view, the bike gets a lot of chrome inserts. Like, this is chrome, the thrash guard is chrome, it gets a chrome side stand, and also the front fairing, the housing for that is also chrome. If you see, even the instrumentation console, the speedometer panel is also chrome. So a lot of chrome parts into the vehicle. And also, if you see the side profile of the exhaust pipe, there is also a lot of chrome inserted into it. So that's how it is. And from the front, if you see, the Cruise gets the LED DRL, and the shape of the headlight is not circle, but it's in this angle format. It gets the turn indicators, which is analog, and these are the flex type ones, so which is good. If you see the rear tail light, it also is in a new pattern, and this one is not LED, but it is a halogen unit. The bulbs also, as I mentioned, in the turn indicators are bulbed. The rear tire is a 130x90, and this is a 15-inch tire, and the front is a 90x90, and these are all tube tires. And if you see, this is the side profile. The rear suspension is the Nitrox 5-step adjustable spring-loaded unit, whereas the front gets a telescopic unit. The braking duties is carried forward by the front being a 280mm disc, which gets ABS, and this is single channel ABS. And the rear is the drum unit, and the rear also gets this speed sensor. So even though it's a drum, I think this is close to 130mm, but it also gets the rear speed sensor. The age-old reliable 220cc DT, around 18 bhp, at 8500 rpm. The torque also good. And if you see, the side stand indicator gets the gearing also is 5-speed, and gear is down, and all the remaining 4 gears are up. The neutral is in the center. The instrumentation console is a completely digital unit, where it gets the trip meters, the odometer, the fuel gauge meter, everything is digital. On the tank, you also have a secondary telltale signs, and there you can see the ABS indicator, the Bluetooth logo, sorry, the Bajaj logo, the ABS and the neutral, and as well as the turn indicators. The switchgear quality is also pretty good, and these are not backlit. With the LED DRL switch, the engine kill switch, and the starter motor, and also you get a pass switch, so which is nice, and the turn by turn indicator cancel switch. So the highlight of the vehicle is certainly the handlebar, which is more cruiser oriented, and if you are somewhere at 5'8" or 6 feet, there is a slight tendency where the handlebar touches your leg when you are turning. But apart from that, the windscreen is pretty good, and certainly gives a lot of wind protection. The mirrors are also nicely shaped and has a very nice look. So talking about the fuel tank, it is a 13-liter fuel tank with a reserve of close to 3 liters, and it has a mileage range of close to around 40 to 42 kilometers, based on how you drive. So this gives a range of around 520 kilometers, so which is pretty good for a cruiser. So the highlight of the vehicle will certainly be the long and a very comfortable seat, primarily catered for the rider. If you see, the seat is very plush and very comfortable, especially for the pillion. I also like the rear rest, so the back rest which is provided for the pillion rider, but the seat is not that spacious, so I guess probably there's some modification that can happen over there. But apart from that, the bike looks from this side very long, and the seating stance is on the cruiser side, where your legs are obviously forward biased. So I hope you enjoyed the walk around shoot, and I hope you found this video informative. The Avenger Cruise 220 on-road price is roughly around 1,40,000+, and this is ex-showroom Hyderabad. And yeah, with that kind of money, you get a very reliable and a very age-old engine, which has proven its mettle, and it comes with a slick gearbox. So with that, you can rest be assured that you are getting a very good product, and the BS6 convenience only adds to the overall package. And apart from that, the bike also gets some nifty new features. The tall windscreen also is really good. So all in all, it's a good package. And I hope if you have found this video informative, please like and subscribe to the channel. This is Kevin signing off, and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.